Hello students. This video is a continuation and a follow-up of our previous video in which I had left you with an exercise to find out that which is your favorite and comfort timings to concentrate during your studies. Now, in this video, I'm going to tell you that how to utilize that time in which you're comfortable studying. Because it is no point sitting in a time to study where you are dozing off to sleep and you are not at all being able to focus and you are distracted. So that time which you have actually understood is the time for you to study at the best. Now that time duration we are going to discuss. Now I am going to divide the students into three categories and the timings again into three categories. So please listen till the end of this video to understand what I want to tell you. Students, you have 24 hours, which is equivalent to 86,400 seconds in a day. And when you multiply these 86,400 seconds with 500 months, you have approximately 1.2 billion seconds to study. To study in. So it's not a small time that you have in hand to study and do well in your exam. It is a huge time duration. When we say 1.2 billion seconds, means the entire universe could be reconstructed again. So that is the time in your hand. So never think it's too late or you cannot do it. Now, coming to the main point, the three types of students. First ones who are self-disciplined, self-motivated. They are the ones who can wake up at the given time they decide to wake up. So they could be the morning risers, which we call. So they decide to wake up at 4 or 5. So they give that time duration to study. And that is the time in which they find peace and they find their brain fresh enough to sit and study. So these type of students are considered as the A category students. These A category students are very comfortable during the morning hours. So when you start in the morning hours, the first subject that you should touch on is subjects like history, geography, subjects which require memorizing like biology, subjects like, you know, English. If you have some difficult terms, if you are weak in English, start with English. Then moving on to the next hour, give half an hour per subject because you have 1.2 billion seconds to work on. So you give half an hour per subject if you have 8 subjects. Now, moving on to the next subject from this is something that is, you know, not just theory, but a merger of theory and practical. Like you have theories in physics and chemistry, as well as you have some practical aspects as well. So you are going to start with subjects like that in the next hour. Then moving on to the next section of your time of 4 hours will be dealing with the practicals like mathematics, which you need to repeat again and again. So this is the time duration which you need to focus. So you divide this 4 hours in the subject in this category. First, which requires memorizing. Second, which is a base of theory and practical. And the third phase will be based on complete practicals. This is for A type of students. This is for A type of students. Moving on to the next type, the B type. They are the students who are disciplined, who are motivated, but not self-motivated, who need a push. So they are the students who would be rather feeling comfortable to study during the time which is evening time, when they come back from school or play or after some kind of an activity. So they are the students who need a bit of push. So they are disciplined, they are obedient, and they are motivated, but they need that push. So that is the time duration which they can find the best suited time to study. So the same thing you have to follow here. The first thing that you're going to sit with will not be exactly like the A group is going to study with. You're going to start with theory and practical. You're going to start with, B will start with theory and practical because you are a person who is, you know, a bit distracted, not completely focused. So you are the category who will need to get that time to settle down, to get that attention and focus in your studies. So here you are the one who's going to start with subjects like physics, chemistry, some geography, if you're art students, if you're in commerce students, then start with accounts, economics, and after that follow the subjects which are like history, which needs memorizing, which needs memory power, because by then you are ready to focus, your concentration is at peak. So you go with biology and the memorizing subjects, then you again move to the subjects which needs a lot of practice, because then again you are a bit tired and you need some practical activity which needs the, you know, action of your hands and stuff so that you can work on it. Now coming to the C category students. C category students are the students who are actually the most intelligent students. But along with their intelligence comes a lot of distraction in them. So they are the ones who keep procrastinating. So they are the ones who love saying 5 minutes later, 10 minutes later and so on. So their favorite time to study is the late night. So now this late night lovers cannot procrastinate beyond 8 p.m. So 8 p.m. to 12 a.m. is your comfort time in which you can concentrate the most. But students, you're going to start in the reverse manner. You're going to start with mathematics. You're going to start with the most difficult subjects. You're going to start with the most, you know, subjects which needs to be practiced. You're going to start with those subjects because you need a longer time to gain your attention and pay attention to what you're doing, because you have a high level of distraction. But with that distraction comes your intelligence. So please don't underestimate yourself or underrate yourself. So start with mathematics, start with accounts, start with subjects like, you know, our students can start with subjects like geography, which has a lot of calculations and all. Then moving on to the next phase of your study duration will be all memorizing subjects like biology, history, you know, if you are problematic with Hindi languages, go on to those subjects. After that, you move on to the again the same, you know, theory practical based subjects, because you are somebody who's going to get distracted very soon. So you need to get that attention again. So you need to practice as well. So physics has something like, you know, theory and sums. So you're going to do that together. So that gives you the focus line. Then you can start with subjects like accounts if you have there. You can have economics there. And for art students, it can be subjects, you know, which you find more difficult, like political science needs a lot of, you know, brain work, how many members are there in, you know, parliament and stuff. So these things are the way you're gonna study. So, you know, according to your personality, you need to choose your time duration. That is why I asked you for this exercise, because telling a general statement for everybody does not actually work. But if you are able to identify your comfort level and your comfort zone, it is not very difficult. Now, after having the timetable, just following the timetable is not going to help you. After following this timetable, you have to remember to have a spaced repetition method. Means you have to schedule your week from Monday to Friday, you have school. Saturday, Sunday, you get the whole day. So morning, evenings, they're also in the schedule. So what you're doing is you're getting extra time there out of this 4 hours. So Monday to Friday, you are getting 4 hours to study. But on Saturdays and Sundays is the time when you can do repetition. Repetition means if you watch television, in those serials also, you get to see the recap. Why do this give you the recap? So that you can relate to what you have done. So that has to be done in your Saturdays and Sundays. So the extra time that you're getting on Saturdays and Sundays is not for you to waste. It's for you to do the repetition of what you have done from Monday to Friday. So this, if you can follow, trust me, and if you can utilize this 1.2 billion seconds constructively, well managed, scheduled, nobody can stop you from scoring high, good marks in your board exams. All the best.